Safari Star.
Biz su içeriz.
Yes, that's right. He's learning Turkish because he's going to come to Turkey with me.
Yeah.
Merhaba arkadaşlar, YouTube kanalıma hoş geldiniz. Ben Cem Emre Şenyurt ve burası Kodlayacağım. Yanımda çok sevdiğim üniversite arkadaşım Kol Perez var. Kendisi Netflix'te yazılım mühendisi olarak çalışıyor. Burada biraz onun hayatıyla alakalı, daha sonra Netflix'e nasıl girdi ve ne yaptı bunlarla alakalı konuşacağız. Kanalıma abone olup bu videoyu beğenirseniz gerçekten çok memnun olurum. Şimdiden zamanınız için teşekkür ederim. Kol. Welcome in, buddy.
Thanks, man. Thanks for
having me. How you doing?
Good. Yeah.
How's your day going so far?
It's going good. Beautiful weather here in
this
the
is the first time interviewing someone.
Yep.
And
that's first time getting interviewed for me.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. This is Kodlayacağım. You know that. You know the concept. And I had a content that I call Who Is This?
Mm-hmm.
So, who's Kol Perez?
It's a loaded question. Kol Perez, I would say. I'm just a regular guy. I work in tech. I do normal stuff outside of it. I love running. I love playing basketball, playing soccer.
Oh, yeah.
I love messing with this guy, hanging out with this guy. Love learning.
We're actually going to go to Turkey together, hopefully, for this year. Yeah. If not, next year for sure.
100%.
He's learning Turkish, too.
Yep.
And he's doing good.
Duolingo.
You're actually, yeah, he's trying on the Duolingo. And his scores are really good. So we'll see what's going on, right? So, Cole, before we actually go into Netflix, because we got to talk a lot of it, can you actually talk about, like, early days in Bakersfield? Like, what'd you do over there? How was your family?
Oh, man, that's so tough talking about. If you're from Bakersfield, you know that there's not much to do there. We usually, like, for fun, we go to Target, actually.
Really?
Like, yeah, there's really nothing to do there. Everything there has to do with the oil fields or, like, teachers or firefighters. So, like, I didn't know anything about tech growing up, honestly.
But, like, how'd you go into it then?
Well, I went to community college after high school. I just took random classes, stumbled across a C++
like some programming classes, like C++, Java. That's what I did too, to be honest.
C++ class. And
yeah.
I realized I liked that more than what I was doing. So then I switched my major to CS.
Oh, that's perfect. Because when you actually love what you do, like especially in tech, it's really important.
Yeah.
Because I see that a lot of people, you know, they do it for money. And I mean, obviously you have to make, like you have to earn your money. That's for sure. But if you actually only passionate about the money in terms of tech, it's going to be really tough. You actually have to love what you do in terms of, you know, you put value on people and like everybody's using your app, like programs like Netflix. The system is unbelievable. Data that you guys are validating is unmatched. It's really big.
Mm-hmm.
So we went to UCI together.
Yeah.
The UCI times were really good. Like we had so much fun out there. Zot, zot, zot. And just say about like our times in UC Irvine.
No, it was great. I had a great time there. I feel like I got to gain a lot of experience there.
Right.
We learned a lot of things. We had some pretty hard classes.
It was really
tough.
We
took them together.
Especially algorithm class was really tough, yeah.
But all that, like, I feel like a lot of those skills, you know, maybe it doesn't translate exactly because you're going to be working on, like, large-scale systems, and you're also going to be working on stuff that is new, you know? Like, everything you're working at when you work at a big company is, like, something that's never been solved before. So you can't directly apply your school knowledge, but you can.
Well, it still makes sense, right? Like, still, you know, you remember your time.
Concepts are there,
right? That's perfect because, you know, everybody asks that question to themselves. Like, yeah, we see that in school, but like, when are we going to use it? Like, how are we going to use it, right? I think that part is really important, especially in computer science, because you learn a lot of theory, and you know, those theory, if that applies to large scalable systems, is really important in a company like Netflix. So, you know, in Kodlayacağım, what I'm actually going to do, indeed, is we'll try to teach people how to actually solve LeetCode problems.
Yeah.
Can you actually talk about your experience in LeetCode? You were expert because you haven't done it for a long time. How people has to go through that phase? Like, is it important?
Yeah.
If it is, like, how is that going to work?
No, so I would say definitely prioritize doing LeetCode, getting good at, you know, data structure, algorithm problems, because, you know, the way that industry works is like that's
especially
what,
in the United States, right?
Yeah, it's what gets you a job. I don't know about other countries, but I know for sure here you want to work for a big company. You know, you got to be good at that. So I think it's something that you have to basically do outside of school. It's unfortunate, but you have to practice it in school and also outside.
Right.
And something like Kodlayacağım is a great thing to do. Because
appreciate it, man.
It's, I mean, I use LeetCode. I don't speak, I use NeetCode. I don't speak Turkish. But the underlying concepts and everything that he'll be teaching you, it will directly translate to.
The reason that actually I conduct everything in Turkish is that there are a lot of resources in English and everybody can be able to see, you know, NeetCode are the top guys that are actually like going through his videos all the time. Like, you know, when we were in undergrad, he's really helpful at that phase. But in Turkish, I actually want to see, you know, our potential, because I know that engineering potential in Turkey is really, really good. It's big, it's bright in the future. But I actually wanted to come with some Turkish resources so that people can be able to see it, and I'll definitely some time to translate everything after we're done with this interview. So then after UC Irvine, you right away could be able to secure your job in Netflix, and that's perfect. I'm proud of you. But before that, of course, you had an internship at Amazon. Let's just talk about your internship at Amazon, and then, let's talk about your time in Netflix.
So I interned at Amazon. It was in the Seattle office. I was interning at Amazon Photos, which is basically, if you've heard of Google Photos, it's very similar to that. It's
Right.
offered for Amazon Prime customers. And actually there I did a lot of front-end work. You can actually check my changes if you go on Amazon Prime, or if you go on Amazon Photos right now.
Right.
My changes on the homepage, so it'd be something you can
So
see.
what'd you change it over there?
So I basically, the filters used to be on the left-hand side, and I transformed it to be like pills. I added some more filters as well, and I just made it a little bit more dynamic.
Okay. So right after that, you had your last year in UC Irvine. We were together. It was really unfortunate for me because I had another semester. I was by myself because you graduated a little bit earlier than me, but that's fine. I mean, we all graduated like at the end of the day. Then you started your time at Netflix. You came to Bay Area. No more SoCal. So would you say, like, what do you think about Bay Area and then your time in Netflix? How is that going so far?
Yeah, so far I've been loving like working at Netflix. It's definitely like one of the best companies to work for in tech, in my opinion.
That's for sure, yes. That's top-notch tech company.
I get like very, very amazing problems. I work with like some of the most talented people, and I work on something that I love watching. Like, I'm a huge Netflix watcher.
Netflix, I
Jen knows
know,
I
I
have basically
know it.
seen every show of
This guy is
Netflix
actually crazy. He
even before
always
it came
watched
out. Yeah,
Netflix.
big fan. So yeah, it's been really cool to work on something that
Right.
I use.
That's actually perfect. I'm actually like super happy for you because you're passionate about it. Like you were watching it, you were a fan. So, what are just some pros and cons of working in Netflix? Like I see that like the environment is unbelievable. There are a lot of bright brains over there. The people that like walks around is like inspiring. So what would you say? I know that you're a great guy, you're a great dude, you work hard. But like how the other people are actually affecting you, and how about the old environment affects all of you guys?
So pros and cons. I would give, like, for me, the biggest pro is the amount of stuff that you can learn. And at the same time, that could be the biggest con, because if
Right.
you're not someone who, like, enjoys learning new things, then that is going to be something that's painful for you.
Right.
But I think that, like, the best part about our job is that you constantly are learning new things and you're getting better, and every day is different, which makes every day not boring. Learning new things every day is like something I really enjoy, and there at Netflix is like you get the opportunity to do that every day. So
That's perfect. Yeah, thank you for sharing some pros and cons in Netflix. A couple of things, a couple of recommendations for the people that who watch this channel. And what do you want to say about working in tech in California and all, like all the United States? What would you say?
I would say that if you can do one thing, I would definitely try and grind to be able to do that, because the ability that the job gives you is, there's no other job like that. Obviously, unless you have your own business, but if you don't, like, you get so much flexibility, you have so much freedom, you have the ability to learn something new every day,
Right.
and at the end of the day, you just got to finish your work. So however you like to structure that, that works best for you. You have the ability to do that.
In the
So
era of 2024, the recruitment seasons are really tough, I would say. But still, there's a hope, right? Like after all these AI revolutions and everything, what would you say that the recruitment will be in the future? Is it like still bright? Like they got to do it, or what would you say about that?
I mean, I think that, yeah, the past few years have been pretty tough, but it's just because it's the way the industry works. Like, we scaled up so fast after COVID that it's just natural for it to come down a little bit. But I wouldn't say to
We'll come
be,
back.
yeah, I wouldn't say to be worried. It's going to be coming back. And if
Okay.
anything, AI is just going to open more jobs for people.
Okay. So Cole, thanks so much for your time here. And this was our first interview, guys. This is called The Jam YouTube channel. Please like the video and subscribe to the channel. Cole, you want to say your last words in Turkish, maybe?
Görüşürüz.
Görüşürüz.
Görüşürüz. Görüşürüz. Yeah, goodbye, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. Keep listening to this guy. He's gonna
Appreciate it, man.
give you a good job.
Hopefully. Thank you, man.